Hello everyone, we have Pallavi Joshi right here with us in the Bay Area. She is the wife of the famous Bollywood director Vivek Agnihotri, and all of you must have known her as a famous television star and a Bollywood actress. It's wonderful having you here on Yo India TV in the Bay Area. And what's the purpose of your visit?
Well, this time we are here on a book tour, which my husband has written. It's a book called Urban Naxals. It's the most talked about book, this year in India. And this is, I think, the first time that this kind of a book tour has been organized for any author, Indian author outside of India. So we are very happy to be in Bay Area, and we've got a tremendous response so far in all the cities that we've traveled.
That's wonderful. So what I know is that the book is based on the movie that was released last year, Buddha in a Traffic Jam. You were one of the actresses in the movie. I think you were playing wife of Anupam Kher, who was playing the role of a professor, and how the professors are instrumental in influencing people to get into intelligent terrorism. So talk a little more about the movie, your role, and how the story is related to the making of the book.
Well, the story is actually Vivek's journey of the experiences that he had, not just while making the film, but more of his experiences after having made the movie, and the resistance that he faced once the movie was shown to people. As far as my character in the movie is concerned, I don't know how to quite say this, but I wasn't going to be part of the movie at all. I was just helping Vivek with the script. Every time he wrote a draft, we would all sit down together. We have a couple of other people in the office. So we all ideate, we brainstorm over the subject. And as we were, ideating, this character of Sheetal, I found certain things in her which I thought were very interesting. So we started talking about it, and then suddenly everybody in the room said, "Oh, why don't you play Sheetal?" And that's how it happened. I wasn't going to be a part of the movie at all. We were just, in the research team all sitting together. But it was wonderful doing this film because, I worked with Vivek after a very long time. We used to work a lot earlier. But so in between, when Vivek just went on to become this huge Bollywood director, and he started making films with John Abraham and Bipasha and Irfan Khan and Anil Kapoor and everyone, I was never part of that kind of cinema. So there was a long gap of time when we hadn't worked together. So it was nice to reconnect with him as an actor, not just as a wife, but as an actor. And it was wonderful being on the sets because it was my own crew, and I knew everyone there. So it was a different kind of I was very comfortable. It was like acting at home for me.
Innocent logon ko marna is not a revolution, it's called murder.
Why don't you just trust me on this also?
I will trust you because I do not have a choice in the matter.
Aur agar koi corrupt nahi hai to sirf ek aisa gareeb aadmi jisko mauka hi nahi mila corrupt hone ka.
Main tumhari political ambition kabhi puri nahi hone dunga.
Join me ek nayi soch ka naya Bharat. Say yes to revolution.
I'm not Naxal. Is that what you're telling me? Are you a Naxal?
Yes, I am. I'm a comrade, and so are you.
सितम सहले तड़प ले रोले अपने अजदाद की मिरास है माजूर है हम चंद रोज और मेरी जान फकत चंद आबूस है गुफ्तार पे ताजीरे हैं
और अपनी हिम्मत है कि हम फिर भी जिए जाते हैं.
So what was the thing in the movie that triggered writing of the book for Vivek, and what was your contribution in the whole process?
Well, actually, my contribution is zero. This is all only him. I can't take any credit for it. As he mentioned in the speech that he just gave, that while doing the research for the film, he realized that there is this huge nexus between the academia, the intelligentsia, and the terror organizations of the country. And he just started putting all the dots together. And when he did that, a lot of people refused to believe that this was the truth, because nobody had gone through this exercise earlier. And the popular narrative, as he again mentioned earlier, is that terrorists are actually good people. This is what we were given to understand even when the Kargil war was on. And one of the journalists, I don't like naming names, but a very senior journalist of the country, she had gone and stayed with the soldiers, and she said that there is, these jihadis are actually, they have a heart of gold. And I don't understand what, why would anyone go and actually sympathize with the people who are barbarians and who are mass murderers? Why do you want to get into their psyche and understand? I mean, in US, when a person killed somebody 40 years ago can still get convicted because he's still as guilty of that crime. And here you have people killing scores of, a barbarian killing scores of people, and you want to dig deep into his psyche and see whether he's actually a good man or not. It doesn't matter. He's a killer, he's a convict, he's a criminal, and he ought to be punished. So while all these things are happening, when Vivek just tried to assimilate the whole thing, it just went against the popular narrative, and that's why there was a lot of resistance. In fact, as he said, that there were a lot of filmmakers that we were friends with, and they kind of started disassociating themselves from us because they felt that we were going against the grain, and this is something, we're treading down a dangerous path, and they didn't really want to belong in the same room as us. So he stood for what he thought was correct, and he fought his way through. He's written this book, and I think he's a man on mission, and he's completely unstoppable now.
And congratulations that the book became an instant hit as well, and now it's in demand, and several publishing houses are asking him to write another book. That's wonderful to hear. Coming to your life, when I was a child, I was watching the TV series Mahachatur Mrigayani, and we were like totally impressed the way the story was designed, you going into the jungle with the kids and in that forest atmosphere, raising the kids so beautifully. I think the theme was beautifully laid out, and your character was a very pleasant character, and you played it so well. You were really popular in our times, I should say. What's your experience in the making of Mrigayani, and if any memories last that you would like to share with the viewers?
Well, Mrigayani is a very popular novel by Vrindavan Lal Varma. So when I heard that Amol Palekar is making this serial, and he wants me to play the character of Ninni in it, I first decided to read the book. And when I read the book, I was gobsmacked because the way Ninni and Man Singh Tomar first met is a very hilarious incident. He was being attacked by a bison. So Ninni just came in between the bison and the king. She got the bison by the horns and she broke his neck, and that's how she saved the king. And when I read this, I used to be reed thin before I got married. I weighed all of 42 kilos, which doesn't even translate into 90 pounds here, And I read that book and I got into a fit of hysteria, and I said, what are you even thinking? I mean, I can't even kill a goat. I mean, forget taking a bison with my bare hands. And that's when Amol Palekar said that it's not the strength of Mrigayani, but the intelligence of Mrigayani that I want to concentrate on, that I want to really bring out. And that's why I want you to play this character. So then we designed it differently. We both sat down, we did some workshops on it, and that's how Ninni was born. And it was beautiful shooting for that serial because, I mean, we are actors, we are used to taking direction from a whole lot of different directors. But when an actor becomes a director, it's a delight to work for him or her. So when Amol Palekar, essentially such a wonderful actor himself, decided to direct me in Mrigayani, the way he would, explain the scene to me. Half my job was already done by just looking at him, and I didn't have to put in that extra effort. It just came so naturally to me by just watching him, you know, explain the scene to us. And I struck up a very, very deep and a meaningful friendship with Mohan Bhandari. Unfortunately, he passed away a couple of years ago. And I lost a very dear friend. But it was the most wonderful time that I had with Mohan and Haider Ali and me and Rekha Sahai and all the queens. So we had this huge group, and I remember on the last day of my shooting, I burst out into tears because I didn't want to go back home and I didn't want the shooting to pack up, you know. It doesn't happen anymore because now this serial stretch on for such a long time that you really want it to end, you want the serial to get over, finish, you want to go home, you want nothing to do with your, you know, co-actors anymore. But of course, it wasn't the case back then because you had like 13 episode, at the most 26 episode serials. So it was a very memorable and fond experience of my life. I
would. Some of the other well-known serials that we remember from our times, like Mr. Yogi, Bharat Ek Khoj, and you have been in acting in them. So I think you've done a lot more TV serials. So you've been on that screen for a long time.
Sub-Lieutenant Nikita Sachdev, Sub-Lieutenant Nivedita Singh.
क्योंकि मैंने डिसाइड किया है कि मैं फौज ज्वाइन करूंगी. आर्मी, एयरफोर्स,
यानी ये कैन यू बिलीव इट, हम लोग गोवा आ गए. वी एक्चुअली जॉइन द मूवी यार.
है ना, मुझे भी बिलीव नहीं हो रहा है. क्या क्या हो गया यार इसकी. मैंने जिस दिन से अप्लाई किया उस दिन से आज तक का वक्त मुझे कुछ पता नहीं चला. इतने दिनों से एस्पायर कर रही थी कि नेवी ज्वाइन करूंगी, अब मेरी पूरी जिंदगी स्मूथ सेलिंग हो जाएगी.
मानवी से यहाँ आराम करने नहीं आए.
यस सर, हम अपनी ट्रेनिंग छोड़कर यहाँ आराम करने नहीं आए. हमारे लायक अगर कोई काम नहीं है तो प्लीज हमें एकेडमी वापस भेज दीजिए.
ऑलराइट देन, तुम लोग किचन में रिपोर्ट करोगे. एंड यू सचदेव, यू विल टेक ऑर्डर्स डायरेक्टली फ्रॉम मी. तुम एंट्रेंस साफ करो.
व्हाट?
ऑन द डबल.
यस सर.
तुम यहाँ क्या कर रही हो?
यू?
यू का मतलब? तुम्हें सीनियर्स को सल्यूट करने की तमीज नहीं? देखो, ये रेजिडेंशियल एरिया है. यहाँ पर तुम्हें आना मना है. अगर कमांडर से मिलना चाहती हो तो कल ऑफिस में मिल लेना.
मैं जानती
हूँ. चोला राज्य के बंदरगाह पुहार में मणिकर नाम का एक प्रसिद्ध व्यापारी रहता था, जो कई जहाजों का मालिक था. उसकी बेटी कन्नगी बहुत खूबसूरत थी. पुहार में ही माँ शट्टुवन नामक एक धनी व्यापारी भी था. उसका बेटा कोवलन एक 16 वर्षीय युवक था. कोवलन और कन्नगी के माता पिता ने उन्हें विवाह सूत्र में बांधने की ठानी.
छोटे से नए फूल प्यारे, छोटे से नए फूल.
धन्य भाग्य मेरे कि तुम्हें पाया मैंने. अमृत के वरदान से विचित्र, सागर मंथन के अमृत कलश से भी दुर्लभ. स्वर्ग की अप्सराएं लज्जा से मुंह छिपा लें, ऐसा सौंदर्य.
कन्नगी, देवंदी अम्मा,
मैंने सुना है तुम्हारे बारे में. तुम फिक्र ना करो, मेरे स्वामी भी मुझे छोड़कर तीर्थ यात्रा को चल दिए, पर तुम्हारे स्वामी तो बुहार में ही हैं. आ जाएंगे। तुम्हारी बात सही हो, परंतु मुझे रात को तरह तरह के डरावने सपने आते हैं। कल रात को ही मैंने देखा कि मैं और मेरे स्वामी कहीं दूसरे नगर में जा रहे हैं। वहां पर कुछ लोगों ने मेरे स्वामी पर आरोप लगा दिया और उन्हें झूठे अपराध में फंसा दिया। तभी मैंने देवी का रूप धारण कर लिया और क्रोध में राजा और नगर को सर्वनाश का श्राप दे दिया।
कौन हो तुम? क्या नाम है तुम्हारा?
जी, मेरा नाम राधा है।
राधा, जैसा नाम वैसे ही गुण। कहाँ रहती हो?
मैं यहाँ की नहीं हूँ, मिर्जापुर से आई हूँ।
अच्छा अच्छा, किसी काम की तलाश में आई हो या किसी से मिलने?
जी, किसी से मिलने आई हूँ, लेकिन पहले उसे ढूंढना भी पड़ेगा ना।
मिल जाएगा, वो तुम्हें जरूर मिल जाएगा।
ये आपने कैसे जाना?
ये इस शहर की खासियत है राधा, यहाँ से कभी कोई खाली हाथ नहीं लौटता। तुम भी नहीं लौटोगी।
सच?
हाँ। यहाँ रहने का कोई ठिकाना है?
नहीं बाबा, मैं यहाँ रहने नहीं आई हूँ। बस अपने कृष्ण कन्हैया के दर्शन हो जाए तो मैं फौरन गांव वापस चली जाऊंगी।
So, how was your experience overall? And if there are any specific memories you want to share with our viewers, please go ahead.
Well, I haven't really counted of late, but the last that I put my profile together, because I was supposed to be on the jury for the national awards, so they had asked for my profile, and that was when a couple of years ago when I counted, I had done about 90 odd serials. I would say that the time when the serials came on Doordarshan was the best time of all, because we only had like a quarter of a year, and those were good old weeklies, and we did nothing more than 13 episodes. If the serial got an extension, at the most 26 episodes, and that used to be the end of it. We used to shoot each episode over a span of 3 to 4 days, so we had a lot of time to be creative about it, go into different shots, discuss, debate on the sets. Now we have to shoot with the daily soaps coming in. There are 26 episodes a month that we have to roll out, so we have to finish one episode in a day, which is ridiculous. It's like shooting a quarter of a film in one day. We normally take anything between 50 to 60 days to shoot a film, but and a film is about 2.5 hours worth, and here a half an hour episode we have to finish in one day, which is a ridiculous comparison of how uncreative you can be on the sets of a television show. So ever since the dailies have come in, television has actually lost its charm, but the good old Doordarshan days were wonderful. We had great directors. There was Ramesh Sippy, there was Govind Nilani, there was Shyam Benegal. They were all doing good stuff on television. They were all, there were a lot of short stories by famous authors, and serials were being made on them. Yash Chopra was making something on Doordarshan. So it was all in all a great time, being on TV. And after that, once all these daily soap directors took over, and it's nothing. It's just like you sit in a taxi, they put the meter down and you pay them at the end of your ride. It's just that you take your money at the end of the day. It's only money now. There is no creative satisfaction left in TV anymore.
So agility has become so much that creativity is kind of taken a backstage. So Pallavi, you have also done numerous movies. I remember you as a part of Saudagar, and then I think you played Kasturba Gandhi in The Making of the Mahatma, and some of the more movies. So tell us your experience about the movies, and why we don't see you in the movies anymore. I mean, we do see you in The Buddha in the Traffic Jam, but as you said that you accidentally came in and then it worked out so well. Obviously, you are talented actress, and I don't know, you have tons of experience now. You may share the same with our viewers.
Sure. See, right from the beginning, my area of interest was never the so-called Bollywood films. I never wanted to become the heroine and run around the trees. Yeah, I mean, every you know, girl aspires to look extremely beautiful. She wants to wear glamorous clothes and she wants to, you know, have a handsome hero courting her in the movies. And she wants to have an item number. But I was somehow never of that mindset. I always, maybe it could be because I come from, I'm the third generation of actors in the family. My grandmother was an actor. My parents had their own theater company. And that's where we actually started working. So for us, the glamour was completely stripped down. And at a very early age, we realized that this is a lot of hard work. And it's only hard work that pays. And it's like any other 9-to-5 job. Sometimes, you know, most of the times we work overtime. So what I wanted to do was, I wanted to play characters, I wanted to do meaningful roles, I wanted to do something where I give back something to the society. And that's why I chose to work with Govindji and, you know, Shyam Benegal and, you know, all these people, Shubhankar Ghosh and Dayal Nailani and everyone.
Hey Raja, kaam bhag raha hai?
मैं तुम लोगों के लिए लकड़ियाँ जमा करने जा रहा हूँ।
हमारे लिए लकड़ियाँ जमा करने क्यों?
तुम लोगों को जलाने के लिए।
जलाने के लिए क्यों?
तुम लोग मर जाओगे इसलिए।
मर जाएंगे? क्यों?
दीदी ने खाने में सही मिलाया।
राजा तो बच्चा है, इसे क्या मालूम? किसकी बात का क्या भरोसा?
हाँ, तुम ठीक कहती हो, इसकी बात का क्या भरोसा? हम भरोसा करेंगे तो तुम्हारी बात का। ठीक है, तुम न सही राजा सही, आखिर पता तो यही लगाना है ना कि खाने में जहर है या नहीं।
I did not give up working, but I just took a little break from acting when the kids came along, because when you're acting, you're on call and you you can't really decide your own work hours. So if I'm called for a 9 o'clock shift, I have to be there at 9 and I can't leave the sets until about 7 or 8 in the evening. And if you're working every day, then it does take a toll on your family life. So when the kids came along, I decided to not act for a bit, but I kept producing. I kept doing my television shows, I kept producing movies, and we were doing our corporate films and our ad films. So I was busy working throughout. It was never like I stopped working. But it was only behind the camera and not in front of the camera. And then Buddha happened, and by the time the kids had started growing up, and they didn't mind, you know, not having their mom for like a few days every now and then. And now that they're all grown up, my son is 17, our daughter is 19 years old, so they actually don't need me anymore. So now is the time that I've started coming in front of the screen again. So I did Peshwa Bajirao, the serial, last year. And the year before that, I did Meri Awaazi Pehchaane. And recently, I just did a Marathi serial called Grahan, which is extremely popular with the Maharashtrians. And I've just produced the film The Tashkent Files, which will be released on the 2nd of October on Shastri Ji's birth anniversary. It deals with his mysterious death in Tashkent. And we are busy with our foundation, I Am Buddha Foundation, and also, you know, a couple of more film projects are in the pipeline. Plus, this whole book thing is happening, so right now life is quite busy. But of course, the acting assignments are continuing now.
Swati! Arey Swati, radio band karo! Swati!
नमस्ते स्मै स्वाति।
सुबह हुई नहीं कि दोनों चालू। हाँ आती हूँ, क्या है?
नमस्ते स्मै स्वाति। नमो नमः नमो नमः। स्वाति
क्या हुआ?
स्वाति वो कल वाली पैंट कहाँ पे है?
अरे ये नया सेट यहाँ पे रखा है, ये पहनो।
वो कल वाली पैंट कहाँ है जो कल पहनी थी मैंने?
वो मैंने धोने में डाल दी।
स्वाति उसमें बबूती रखी थी मैंने।
क्या थी?
बबूती जो बेतला माता से लाया था ना।
नहीं नहीं मैंने चेक करके डाला था, उसमें कुछ नहीं था।
छोटी सी पुड़की थी स्वाति।
बैग में देखे
क्या? मुझे अच्छी तरह याद है पैंट में रखी थी मैंने। तुम बिना बिल्कुल ध्यान नहीं रखती। कोई
लगता है आपको सीटी ने बहुत परेशान किया मैडम।
चलिए आपकी सीटी की प्रॉब्लम हमेशा के लिए सोल्व कर देते हैं। चंद्रू वो नया वाला मॉडल का ड्रेस राजा 5 लीटर। आराम से ये देखिए मैडम, एकदम नई चीज है मार्केट में, फुल्ली ऑटोमेटिक। सीटी का कोई झंझट ही नहीं है, चावल देखते ही समझ जाता है कि कितनी सीटी मारनी है। बढ़िया है।
वारंटी कितनी है इसकी?
3 महीने की कंपनी की है और अपनी तो लाइफ टाइम है। जब भी कोई प्रॉब्लम आएगी आ जाएंगे।
मतलब प्रॉब्लम आएगी?
अरे मैडम आराम से, एक मिनट। ये देखो हल्के से हैंडल दबाओ, रिलीज करो, टर्न कीजिए, खुल गया। नो टेंशन नो प्रेशर। देखो ट्राई करो।
कितने का है ये?
800 ओनली।
एक काम करिए, एक सस्ता वाला दिखा दीजिए।
अरे मैडम इससे कम में ना आपकी सीटी की प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व नहीं होगी, देख लो। अच्छा चलिए आपके लिए 50 रुपए डिस्काउंट बस, ठीक है?
सिर्फ 50?
अच्छा चलिए आपकी बिना का स्पाइस पे 20 रुपए और।
That's wonderful. So, would you like to share something from the Peshwa Bajirao that was your recent project?
Well, Peshwa Bajirao was very interesting because I was supposed to play Warrior Queen, and long time ago, when I did Mrignaini, which was in the late 80s, Mrignaini was a Warrior Queen, and when she was pregnant with her twins, she actually went and fought a war alongside her husband. So I had done a lot of horse riding that time, and you know, we'd done the war sequences and stuff. But after that, these kind of characters never came my way. So after a long time, I got to play a Warrior Queen where I had to fight battles. And there was a lot of sword fighting, there was a lot of, the Marathi martial arts are called Mardani Khel. So there was a lot of Mardani Khel that I had to practice, you know, when you just kind of keep twirling a bamboo in your hand and that.
So how long it took for you to learn all that?
Well, it can actually take you up to 6 to 8 months to really, be perfect at the art, but I had to do it for camera, so I took about a week. So after about every 10 tours the bamboo would fall but then that's okay, until then the shot was done. So I did a lot of sword fighting, there was a lot of archery involved, there was a lot of Mardani Khel involved, there was a lot of galloping, full galloping on horseback involved. So it was a good departure from, you know, the normal things that I've been doing, very emotional characters. Thanks to my face, people, expect me to play very seedhi saadhi kind of, girl's roles. So this was a complete departure from that, and it was great fun.
Awesome. So all the very best for your next movie. Any final message that you would like to give out to your India TV viewers and maybe the aspiring actors and actresses?
To the viewers, I would certainly like to say that watch out for the next movie, The Tashkent Files. This was not our idea, but this film has been made with your ideas, because for the first time, this film was made with where we sourced ideas from people. We asked them what they knew about Shastriji to, you know, come forth and tell us, because we had filed a lot of RTIs with the government. We were sent from pillar to post. We were first sent to the archives. From there, we were sent to the PMO. From there, we were sent to the defense. From there, we were sent to the Ministry of External Affairs. And of course, there is no paper, forget a file, there is not a single paper available on Lal Bahadur Shastri's visit to Tashkent or on his death. So we asked people to, crowdsource ideas for us, and that's how this film is being made. So I would just like to make another appeal to all our viewers that if you come across any such idea which has essentially an Indian story and which you think that should it should come in front of people, then please write to us. You can look up Vivek on Twitter. Unfortunately, I'm not on any social media platforms, but you can write into us on at iambuddha.com and give us your ideas and we'll make those movies for you.
Thank you so much, Pallavi. Really appreciate your time and best wishes.
Thank you very much. Hi, everyone. This is Pallavi Joshi and you can watch me on Yo India TV.